afternoon. Thursday radio announcer. None by me.
Awesome.
Yeah, go ahead. You gotta buy me a Whopper. Alright, make it 2 tubs of chili from Wednesday.
Well, hello everybody, and welcome to today's stream. Launch this and launch that. Put that up for now. Good afternoon, everybody. Today we're going to be taking an empty grain train towards Seligman. Now, there is no way we will be able to run this till to the end, because that would be a 7-8 hour drive, and I don't think I'm going to be able to stream for 8 hours straight. I mean, never say never, right? But I think it's fairly safe to say never on that one. Bina M2, right? Should be this one here then. There is Bina, and there should be on main 2 should be our train. Put that away, put that away. Go like this, and here we go. Bina main 2, there should be a 6,000 foot 3,000 ton light grain train waiting for me. If this is not my train, then I'm walking here for none. That better be my train. Hey, Brett. Welcome to the stream. The lovely thing about the stream at this time of the day is you guys can actually see the train for once, and the terrain around the train. BNSF 976. Is it you I'm looking for? Oh, it most certainly is. And all the way to Seligman. In theory. Yeah, I'm kind of curious how far we get today. But I guess we'll see. To idle on the Alex a little bit rough there? I don't think that I'm idling rough, but thanks. Thanks for your concern.
Bring me back to the joint, Daddy.
Yeah, exactly. So this is going to be a really fast train because we're empty. We are completely empty. Oh yeah, of course we have speed limits, but we can actually run the speed limit for once. I think that would have been an interesting job, yes. I mean, there was a time in my life in 2009, where I was thinking about becoming a conductor with CN. because I had some friends that were with CN, and they said it's actually a quite interesting job. And so it was definitely something that I considered for a while. But so now I got my counter on, because once we are off the siding, we then indeed can run speed limit here, which is 35 miles an hour. Woohoo. Yeah, for me now, I mean, where I am in my job now, it would be absolutely insanity to do anything else at this point.
Roger that, y'all on duty 5 o'clock, right over. 9:10, Roger that, gonna get a retrain by you, they're coming through.
Dirty BNSF. Yeah, lights and more. Same here. Well, I'm about to hit the 4-1 in May, so yeah. I'm good. Oh, happy birthday. No, I was a child of the 70s, the very end, but hey. Yeah, exactly. We are still Gen Xers. There you go. Yeah, imagine if we were millennials, then we would have to talk like that all the time with a lot of fry in the voice.
Won't crank or just won't fire?
Won't crank.
I'm good on that. Alright, another 2,000 feet before we can throttle up. Well, technically I'm 2 miles too fast right now, but nobody's. So in theory, our trip would take us all the way to Seligman. This is where this train is gonna go, but unfortunately, we just don't have the time. The good news is we really don't have to worry about hills one way or the other, because this thing is just rocking and rolling. You know what I'm saying? Hi. 900 more feet. Alex, did you know that there's a tow truck tow? A tow truck tow? Huh? What's a tow truck tow?
6008, red zone.
Red zone for the 6008, I'm setting center for you, over.
And rock that thing. Yeah, this time you guys can actually appreciate the landscape, because for once we're not running in the dark. It's Y7, but it's Garfield. Garfield is Garfield is a funny, fat, lazy cat. He's kinda like Anakin, just orange. Hey Hagen! Welcome to the stream. What an exciting view. BNSF doesn't wig-wag. I was told by railroaders from BNSF, BNSF does not wake back.
Thank you, Metro. It's always a
that being said, no. The ditch lights don't work either, though, on this. Quite a nasty grade. If you would have to go up with a loaded train, that would have been a lot more interesting. Do
down. You can just stay there.
Horse. Well, lights and more, maybe you should check what you wrote. Then you know why the bot checked you. Reread it.
Bring me back to the joint, Daddy.
No, that's not what you wrote. That might have been what you wanted to write, but that was definitely not what you wrote. Yeah, I know all about that. I know all about that. Oh yeah, of course. Absolutely. That is an interesting train. I bet you any money she's loaded too, because with so many DPUs and middles and... I wonder how many pushers they have. Oh, look at that. They have the DPUs run against each other. That's cute. Oh, the middle DPUs. Hey, Iponoop, so welcome to the stream. Oh my, only one, hey? Huh. Well then. On Tuesday or Wednesday?
3040, that's 340 to Wilson. From control point Z177, on the siding, no switch. Control point Z178, on the siding, switch, no. Rental $200, dispatch ARW, over.
Good sea-based cargo transportation simulation game. No. Honestly, no. I wish I could tell you.
Yeah, he's coming down. You can just stay there.
No, I know, it's yeah, it's a thing. I speak French. No. What's the difference between Namenstag and Geburtstag? Well, there are certain days in the year that are considered name, like it's the, well, quote unquote, the birthday of your name, if you will. And your birthday is, well, your birthday. So it's names day and birthday. That's the difference. Mm-hmm. Noisy little train. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that's fun. Hey, Kleines. Oh, good. UP8324 has a problem.
Who's that?
Yeah, that's me. Sorry.
No problem.
A little bit excessive. Man, running an empty train is so easy, though. I have barely 3,300 tons.
What are you running?
All that XHNSCISI.
Oh.
110 empties. Not like the Widowmaker. Wow, that's long. That's much. You have been waiting for more Into the Flames videos. Well, there might be more Into the lights. Excessive angle is usually when something happened that he ran a switch. That's the only way you can get excessive coupler angles. Oh yeah, he is right on the switch for the yard. He was going into a yard. Oh, yeah. Ah, you know how that goes sometimes. Now that is a good question that I was asking myself, and I do not have the answer for that. Yeah, that is most likely the case.
Hey, that train gone from Vina. Had that train from Vina.
Yeah, the,
oh,
305 X8 X-ray Hotel, Mambo 250.740.
Yeah.
You got that train from Vina?
I think that's 23 clear.
Oh? Yeah, it was a crew call.
Cool. I never use crew call because I always get hung with stuff I don't want.
Well, you want to take over?
No. I got other goodies to run.
Oh, what'd he get? Oh, yeah, you're welcome.
It's a pain to route AI around those trains parked at Vina.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm kind of curious how far I'm going to get her. I mean, I would like to get her maybe to Barstow, but no. Somewhere in Indiana.
We hold this far, thank you for switching it over.
Indiana said, why not? Being SF-15.
I'll park.
Hey, being SF-15-74, hold far, thank you for switching
over. That is correct, over.
Hey, thank you, Dad.
Thank you. So what goodies are running you today? Yeah, one of these days I'm gonna be brave enough to run a local. It's not today. Hey, have you guys seen that new Asila from Amtrak? Yeah. I just absolutely love when you come out of a tunnel at run 8 and you just have the black smoke wallowing out. DJ Finers, thank you for the raid. Yeah, that is pretty cool. Oh yeah, blackout. Alberta for the win. Oh, I don't know what we are winning at the moment. Not much. Thank you for the raid.
Barstow 105A.
Hope you had a fantastic stream. Yeah, Northern Alberta here. About a good 3 hours north of Edmonton. I hit the wrong... I hit my lever and I didn't mean to. Dang it. Oh yeah. Yeah, the oil and gas. No, more to the, well, Peace River is, what is Peace River is west of us, northwest of us. No, enslave. Oh yeah, it is. It is indeed. It is indeed. Ja, Perilla, hab ich. Yeah, I forgot to honk the horn. Look at the smoke coming out of the tunnel. Yes, it is blackout. Well, the same is true for me. I worked in southern Alberta for a while. Near Brooks. As a ranch hand. In Lomond, to be exactly. But, of course, nobody knows where Lomond is, so. Hey, Fred. Glücklich jetzt, Perilla? Ja? One of those climbs here where you just can't win. Oh, you lived in Brooks for a year, nice. If you like the smell of the... Well, depending on how the wind... blows. Just pulling an empty grain train.
Plus my frame rate seems to take a right whack in that area.
I dropped down to about 30 when I'm in that area.
That's constantly spawning trains and scenery buildings.
Yeah.
It's a really light train, it's only 3,300 tons. MacLeod, yeah, that's an interesting place too. Can be interesting. But yeah, 5.4 horsepower per ton. Yeah, you delete it. When it says delete at EOT, then I usually delete them because There's nothing anymore that anybody needs. Just make sure you don't have any orders. Yeah, on the OC you just delete it. Once you are sure you have all your orders are out of the train, then you delete it. I don't think I have to worry about this today with my train.
What train are you on?
XHNSC ISI 20. That's the empty grain train that goes to what's it called? Island.
Seligman.
Yeah, it goes to the end of Seligman, yeah. Yeah, that's what's left for my stupid German accent. Came to war 15 years ago. Yeah. Should be fairly smooth sailing though.
I've heard that the Seligman route is pretty featureless, is that right? It looks like a desert.
I don't know, but I guess it's probably pretty much like needles.
Yeah, it's just us asking around like for the next route and people are saying San Bernardino is a bit more interesting. Even put industry tags on locations, that's my frame right down.
UP detector, milepost 347.0.
I have to turn my vegetation all the way off, or it slows my frame rate down where I look like I'm not even moving.
It can't be very well optimized, this game. I run a 2080 Ti and my computer dies.
With a heavy Westphalian accent. Oh, that must be interesting. That must be interesting. Would appear. Oh, that's a nice view right there. If I only knew how to take screenshots in this game. Sorry, Sim. This is not a game. This is a simulator. Big difference. Yeah, but this is not Steam. So whereabouts in Northern Alberta are you working? What's that?
I'm running the left bar, and that's how you heard this to fall back.
Oh, okay. You're speaking of hardcore. Did you hear what Mark did the other day? He came from a two-day run, and then he spent about 13 hours in run 8.
He has an addiction.
You think?
We all
have. I run about 3 hours every day.
I run about 4 every other. I think that's enough. Well, today I'm going to be running more, but...
Alex, you've got really good HPT on that train.
Oh yeah, 5.4.
Well, that's even higher than
it is. It can power up the mount.
UT detector, mile...
Yep.
3, 4, 7, 0. No defect. Total axle. 4, 6, 4. Train speed, 1, 6. MPH. Temperature, 7, 3. Out.
Small phone. Yeah, I know. I know all about that. Hey, Blackout. Absolutely. Pleasure meeting you. I stream almost daily, so if you happen to be around again, then we'll see ya. Hey, hello. Welcome to the stream. But all aboard. Let me mute the stream.
Let me do this. When you open two tabs, one for the web page run and the other one for your email.
Okay, hang on.
Oh, Cat, I came back, oh wow, probably 4 months ago. YouTube is done, man. Like I upload maybe a video every every 2-3 videos a week maybe. How you doing, Ty? Good to see you, buddy. No, no, probably not, eh? I'm glad to hear that. No?
Won't crank or just won't fire?
Won't crank.
Oh yeah, of course. That'll do it. How's she doing? Keeping you busy, buddy? Climbing all over everything. That's what I told you, brother. I told you, you're in for it. Once she figured out how that climbing thing works, you are in trouble. I know all about that.
I was at deck flight with your ex.
Oh boy, how did that turn out? Too smart for her own gun, yeah. Did you get any flying time lately? Like, RL? By the way, guys, I don't think I have to tell you. I don't think I have to tell you who Cat Strader is, but if I do have to, then. You really want to. You really want to subscribe to him or follow him. He's A, a good friend, B, flight simulator per excellence. Hey, Tua. Oh man, believe me, I would love to. Not one, two up. I'm running an empty train. No, no derailing or decoupling there. Yeah, this train is only 3,000 tons, so there is no ripping this thing apart. Well, I mean, you can rip it apart if you really try, but... Yeah, you have to really try. What I love about this, though, is when you come run 8 through a tunnel... And, then the smoke that comes out, eh? After your train leaves. Look at this. Yes, yes, you can.
Thank you.
Run fun. Or notch fun, sorry. There she be. Yeah, actually, I have to throttle down every now and again. I mean, now, for example. Oh, that might have been a little bit early. Oh, easy there, boy. Baby. I got a little bit nervous there. Yeah, I throttled down too early. I should have waited longer. That was my mistake. Absolutely. In VR, nonetheless. In VR, you betcha. Yeah, Ty, if you are still here, so Run 8, I don't know if you know anything about it, but this is pretty much the flight simulator or the X-plane of train simulators.
Thank you,
Metro. Really? Oh, yeah. No, this is full release.
Brian, you out there?
World of Warcraft. Yeah, see, I never got into that. That's a book with seven seals to me. See, with Run 8, the interesting part is, A, it's multiplayer, so you can run multiple crews, and if you have more than one guy on the train, then it becomes interesting if you run industries, because you have to make setouts and pickups, and have to shunt the train around back and forth, and that's... I mean, for me personally, I like to run road trains, which means... Oh yeah, it is. It is. And it's like this sim is so realistic that there is a lot of real railroaders that are actually playing it. No, to this Run 8 is the X plane of train simulators. Oh, I have to actually power down because I'm too fast. Hey, Nikki! Later. Alright, Ty. Well, good seeing you, brother. We'll chat soon. How's it going, Nick? I don't know. I know that a couple of members in the community run fairly old systems, and they run it fine, so... Can't be too bad. Now, for me, it's easy to say. I mean, I have a... I have a fairly good... computer, so I can't really say one way or another. I think it's not too bad though. Now we are going down the hill. Thank you.
down. You can just stay there.
No, hello, no, it doesn't. Tua, I'm not 100% sure yet, to be honest with you. A while, anyway.
Hitters, point back to 20 on the bar.
Well, look on the look on the train map. They are not all in the north. That's not true. I am running only north because the other ones don't appeal to me at all. But there are other runs. BNSF 9067, advance approach 3556 out. Yeah, I know. How do I have an advanced approach all of a sudden? By the way. Yes.
Roger that. Y'all on duty 5 o'clock, right over. 9-10, roger that. Don't get a
retrain
by you. They're coming
to Barstow now. Venus F9067, diverging clear out. What if I want to make a left turn, though? What if I want to make a left turn, though?
Okay, go ahead.
Plenty of time.
Okay, 6008, red zone.
Thing all the time in my face there. Hey Gunther, welcome to the stream. Thanks for the host, eh? Uh-oh, me is too fast. Oh no, Bulldog, with this one, this train weighs barely 3,000 tons, like 3355. So, yeah, I don't need pushers. I can just... I can just roll down the hill and up the hill and really power up the hills. It's 105 empty, so there's really no need.
Long trains, don't you?
Yes, and heavy.
That's what I always hear from people with small trains.
Oh man,
yeah. That's what I wanted to say
Next, you're gonna tell us it's all about the technique, too, eh?
Always technique, baby.
All right, let's take that to the next level. So, if you have a long train, you don't need much technique. You just let her go.
What use is a long train if you can't go all the way?
Touché.
And you just need a longer train.
You gotta get it up over the hill first.
Yep. Yeah, it can be. Oh, that's actually the sun reflecting off the fireplace. Hey, Knight Rider. Am I getting SnowRunner? Most likely, yes. I can show you guys where we are right now and where we have to go. So we are right now. We are right now here, 9067. Yeah, 9067. And then we go here, and then we're gonna go here at the BNSF junction. We're gonna cross over to Sunborn, and then we're gonna go all the way over. Until we are down here at Seligman. So we're gonna come here, Sandborn, Bissell, Edwards, Sill, Boron, Hinckley. All the way down here to Seligman. Which is going to be a little bit of a run. So that would be, if I would run that today, just so you get an idea of how far we are talking, that would be about 8 hours more from this point on. So needless to say, we're not going that far. No, they would just recrew. After 12 hours, they recrew.
USF 742.
little bit fast there. Where are you hiding? No, Bulldog. But that being said, let me see if this is gonna work. Probably not, but hey. Hey Rick, how you doing, buddy? That being said, covered in drywall dust. Oh, fun. Yeah, you can keep it, brother. You can keep it. Oh, yeah.
Okay,
I'm sure.
Red zone.
Red zone for the 6,000. Yeah, don't mind the yoke here. Because trains and planes is what I do, but the train driver is sitting on top of my Yoko. Just this thing. There we go. Yeah, no, buddy. Drywall dust, I'm good. You can just keep that. Yes, that is made for the sim. No, you can order that from Precision Engineering. So what are you drywalling in all? Oh, I guess if you are covered in drywall dust, you are mudding right now. UP detector.
Hey Brian, you out there?
Detector, milepost 363.0, track 1.
Please, no defects. Please, 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 please. I don't play on any consoles. PC. By Fire Wolf Gaming, welcome to welcome to the stream. Apparently I can't talk anymore, that's good. Venus F 9067 emergency.
What happened?
Dragon equipment according to the detector.
You don't have to go in emergency. Just stop. Just slow down. Stop it when you have to.
Understanding B-47 Barnett, releasing track time authority number 7786 on the siding between CP Soledad, CP Lane 813, 813 AM.
Well, that's just lovely. Now we're gonna walk alongside the train and look for the defective equipment. Well, we're gonna see. What's gonna probably happen is we're gonna be, since we are close to the yard, I'm just gonna have a look here. alongside the train. And then we're gonna throw that whichever card is broken, we're gonna cut it out and leave it at the yard, and then yeah, depending on what car it is, I'm just gonna cut it out and leave it in
No, just repair it. Just repair it and go on.
Yeah?
Just repair it. That could be a car that needs to go to an industry. Just repair it. If it's a hot axle, hit click hot axle. If it's dragging, just hit dragging. That's what I do. No reason to set the car out.
Oh, where is it though? That is a long train. That's why the train does this ever fail. Too doof. Yes, fire. I can call you fire. Ah, there. No, it's not quite the last car. What do we have? What do we have? Dragon equipment, of course. Fix it. Yeah, if it's dragon equipment, that's easy to fix anyway. Hot axle, yeah, different story. Oh, there's the UP-8678. Now, if you think my train is long. Later. That was silly. Time for this. All right.
Hello, Michael.
Hey, Benjamin. Have to wait for the flow to be under 86. Off we go. Hey Pat, welcome to the stream.
Green 2, switch, or note the signal, frequency 177. On the main track, switch yes when you're ready, Art. Can even see the train in the daylight this time. You got some dragon equipment too, eh? No kidding.
Yeah, exactly. Later. Hey, Neil. Good afternoon. Yes, everything is well. Thanks for asking. How about yourself? Wonderful.
Roger that, y'all on duty 5 o'clock, right over. 9:10, roger that. Don't get a retrain by you, they're coming through parts of the hole.
Throttle modulation is the name of the game. Gotta modulate your throttle up and down and up and down and up and down and up and down until you get where you're going. Yeah. Should be good here. MWCBKX. Am I familiar with Black Box? No. Well, in what regard? Aviation? Yes.
Roger that. You're on duty 5 o'clock. Right over. 9-10, roger that. Don't get an E-train by you, they're coming to
Marshall. Oh, a streamer named Black Box. No, I'm not familiar. I'm not familiar with that at all.
Bring me back to the joint desk.
He's getting ready to come into Woodford.
Yeah, I seen that.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah, I was just asking if you want me to stop the cable and let you come up the hill there, because we can only fit in Woodford. It's the sort of last side.
Yeah, I don't think they would ever stop it up this way, but whatever you want
to
do.
Oh, very cool. That one. Yeah. That's about right. Oh yeah, there is no rushing the railroad. Mm-mm. It's so funny when you let the slack out of the train. Oh yeah, you can run a hump. That's what Mark is doing most of the time. He's humping cars. In Barstow. At the classification yard.
Understanding B-47 Barnett releasing track time story number 7786 on the site. Between CB Soledad and CB Lane E13, 813 AM.
Well, when Mark is on the next time and he's humping cars, I'm gonna be I'm gonna stop there and show you guys. Because I can't run a yard. That's just... Can't do what I want to do right now. Yeah, fire, we're talking about a classification yard. Humping cars, meaning sending the cars over the hump and down into the yard for classification and then to put new trains together. This is gonna be interesting. Yes, really. That is the tractive effort that the engine is at the moment putting out. Well, in this case, it's the tractive effort to slow it down, which is at the moment 5,000 pounds, 13,000 pounds. Because at the moment, we have the dynamic brake on. And once you accelerate, that's when you are seeing those numbers in green. Because that's then the tractive effort put forth to accelerate the train. And this is not going to work. Maybe.
UP detector, milepost 377.0, track 1.
And what will this UP detector tell us? Good question. Now, is this train going to be out of my way soon enough? I wonder. Just gonna slow down now because we are coming up on a red signal here right away otherwise. So I'm hoping that the train will be well out of our way before we reach it. The BNSF 9031 is coming down from Sanborn right now, and which is what we... But you have to set your preference first, what you want.
Where do you set that?
In your profile.
Gotcha.
Hey James.
Thank you.
No defects. Oh, good. Venus F9067, approach medium out. I'm doing well, thanks for asking. How about yourself? Oh, Raven. Very, 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 very seldom. Oh yeah, this is a really restful one.
I was at deck flight with your X-ray fan lap with D59.90.
VNSF 9067, approach 3467 out. Yeah, that's a priority train. It's mainly UPS trailers and all kinds of funky stuff. No, that's part of my that's part of the box that I use for truck sim, actually. But it works just as well with this. Very soon.
Hi.
Hey Tanner, welcome to the stream. Divergent clear. Venus F9067, divergent clear, out. There. 13 until this counter is at 15 miles per hour, until this counter here is at zero, because we are still getting the rest of the train. As you can see here, the rest of the train is still on the Mojave sub. So we want to wait. Until the train is clear. And then we can go back to train speed. To track speed. Another 3,000 feet, or 3,700. Oh, snow can come up until the beginning of May.
Yeah, it's probably close enough to just go on down to it. We'll give it a hold up.
Mind you, that year when I broke my leg, which was the 7th of June, 1 week earlier I was still working in snow, so... Although, that was a little bit extreme. Normally it's not that bad. Probably gonna park the train at Bizarre 15 minutes. No, Pat, not really. Gibt es Dönerwetter? Siehst du? Dönerwetter. Yeah. What's in what? No, I didn't. I said something in German. Doesn't matter what I said. Oh, hey, Olivia.
BNSF detector, milepost 813.0.
Run fun!
I think I saw you a remote qualified dollar.
I'm gonna tire down at Bissell.
Alex?
Yeah.
You're gonna put it in Bissell?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm not gonna make her all the way. Hey Brandon, welcome to the stream. The avalanche safety briefing, oh that's fun.
Detector, milepost 813.0. No defects.
No defects. No defects. That's what I like.
6-4 train speed 5.5 mph. Temperature 6.9.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry.
Out.
I think I'm gonna finish that run tonight, unless somebody else wants to. Oh, Pat, it's the first time when you give a briefing to a big group, it feels a little bit awkward, but I get used to it. Out of all the briefings that I do, avalanche, yeah. Who are you getting to brief? Oh, approach diverging. Oh no, that's an approach. Well, UP it would be approach diverging. As it is, this is a approach a medium. BNSF 9067 approach medium 8070 out. Hey, Simon. Hey Green Day, I am doing very well. Thanks for asking. How about yourself? Service to SEC, there's a service area for avalanche surfing before the avalanche scenery starts. A bunch of people who I expect are skiers, residents of the four counties. Ah, I see, I see. Nesca and my stream, nice. Nice combination. My job? Oh yeah. Incident, accident, you name it. On the one side, the action, on the other one, not so much. BNSF 9067 diverging approach, East Brazil, out.
That's correct, yeah.
And that was a clay that I just run over.
Crank or just won't fire?
Won't crank.
didn't feel a thing, no. There's the BNSF 9254 coming our way. So 1700 more feet of this train want to go in the siding and then we can tie her down. And this, my friends, is the end. Hope you enjoyed the stream. I will be back tonight with more streamy goodness. Until then, Northern Alex signing off. Thanks for watching, and God bless.
Past.